the crime side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job, had second hands. Moms bounced on old men, so then we moved to Shaolin Land.
Okay, so I'm so excited to talk to you. I have been such a huge fan of your work since Dope. That's when you got on my radar.
Awesome.
So I've been a very, yes, I've been a huge fan of your work. Dope, Shaolin, fantastic, Spider-Man, of course. What a time to be alive for you.
Right. Thank you. I'm humbled by the progression.
Yes, it's been so awesome to watch. And now we are at Wu-Tang, An American Saga. So listen, it's so funny because I just wanted to let you know that I was originally like the unofficial 10th member of the Wu-Tang Clan. But, like, the paperwork didn't go through. But we just working on it. You know what I'm saying? The paperwork didn't go through.
Right.
But, yes, so I have been, you know, Wu-Tang forever. And I'm very excited about this project, which is coming to Hulu. And I got even more excited when I found out you were a part of it. Can you tell me about your role as Sha?
Sha, I'm playing Raekwon the Chef. Really, we're in the early stages of Wu-Tang. Essentially, this is all before most of them even knew each other, you know, and the ones that did know each other were enemies, you know, and we show how RZA kind of brought all his peoples together to create a crew and, you know, propel each other to the next level. So, it's a really special project, and I'm excited for September 4th. We're premiering, like, I think the first 3 episodes on September 4th. So.
Oh, good. Good. So I can deep dive in from the very beginning. So
yeah.
My question to you, the Wu-Tang is celebrating their 25th anniversary this year. Of course, Enter the Wu-Tang 36 Chambers. For some reason, my vocals got left off the album, but we'll talk about that later. You weren't even born yet. You were a baby or a little toddler at the height of the Wu-Tang's, you know, their rise to fame. So how did you prepare to play the role of Raekwon?
Well, I was filming in Canada for another project coming out at the end of the year called Let It Snow. And Raekwon flew out to Canada and met me at this Asian restaurant. And it was cool. I mean, it was pretty straightforward. I was just taking in his energy, you know, just getting to know him. And while filming the role, I would call him, or I would send videos, or I would record voice memos, and he'd send voice memos back. He'd call me. It was just kind of like, basically, he knew we had a mission for me. I was focused on making him proud of the performance I put on as him. You know what I mean? So I would ask, like, you know, this is the scene. How did it really go down? And then he would tell me, and if it's not really in there the same way, I can play his emotions well, you know what I'm saying, and accurate so that he feels like his story is being represented. So it was cool. We were a good duo, a good team.
Yes, I'm excited to see you portray Raekwon because he has, like, this swag about him that is it's just different from the rest of the Wu members, but I thought that was pretty dope. Now, is this the first time that you are actually portraying someone who is a living person? That, because most of your roles, you've had, like, kind of creative freedom as far as, you know, the character. So how does that differ when you're playing someone that you can actually call and say, hey, man, okay, so did you smack him with the left hand or did you smack him with the right hand?
Right. So basically, I mean, that was essentially it. That's the big difference. And, you know, it's not that one is easier than the other. It's just, it's a different task, you know. It's a different task.
Yes.
With this, I get to experiment with, you know, accuracy versus creativity, if that makes sense.
Gotcha. I do. What do you think fans, or why would you tell, well, naturally, Wu-Tang fans will be tuned in, but for someone who may not be as familiar with the Wu-Tang Clan as they should be, even though I would be side-eyeing them, what would you tell them why they should tune in and check out Wu-Tang, An American Saga?
I think, you know, the Wu-Tang is the iconic group, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot that we don't know about them, you know what I mean? And
yes.
Their stories are relevant to the stories of, you know, Black youth today. And, you know, Wu-Tang is basically a group of quote-unquote felons that end up naming themselves after, you know, the Wu, which is an Asian name, you know what I mean? Wu-Tang.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got, you know, 10, you know, 9, 10 members, you know what I'm saying, from straight out the hood, rapping on some gangster shit. It's just
yourself.
Telling that story and how they became them, you know, and the trials and tribulations of that is worth, you know, taking a look at. And the first episode will have you hooked. So, I mean, just from there on, you know, if you needed a reason to go watch it, you know, you just need Ashton Sanders, who played in Moonlight. We got Dave East playing Method Man. You know, the girls love Dave. And so it's just like that. Those cast members by itself is like great casting for this show. In case you need to know, you know, if it's going to be good.
Well, I'm very excited. Before I let you go, I have to know what your favorite Wu-Tang Clan song is.
Oh, it differs every day. But right now it's Ice Cream.
Well, thank you. That is my personal favorite as well, as owner of Ice Cream Conversations.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yes, that is my favorite. Yes, that is one of my favorites. But yes, it was a pleasure speaking with you. Just congratulations on all of your success and all of the big and great things you're doing. I'm also excited about another project you have coming up, but hopefully I'll get to talk to you about that when that comes back around. But just congratulations, and I'm excited. I will be tuned in on September 4th, and I'm excited for you. I'm very excited for you. I'm excited for this project.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. It was a pleasure speaking with you. Have a great day.
You too. Bye.
Bye-bye.